discrete probability distribution can be presented in tabular form similar to this. It can also be presented using graphical form. Let's do that. And we are going to use this data. The horizontal axis is for the specific value. So let us write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The vertical axis is for the corresponding probabilities. Our lowest probability is 0.1. Maybe we can start from there. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. When the specific value is 1, we have 0.15. It is somewhere here. This is 1, this is 2. The specific value is the midpoint of the base of the rectangle we are going to draw here. So yeah, 0.15. yeah. Okay, and then when the specific value is 2, 0.25, maybe here. So when the specific value is 3, 0.35. When the specific value is 4, 0.15. So yeah, when the specific value is 5, 0.1. So this is the graph, and it is called the probability histogram. Probability histogram. Notice that the base is equal to 1 unit. From here until here is 1 unit. This is the midpoint. This is the midpoint. So this is equal to 1 unit. And this is equal to 0.15. If we multiply this 1 by 0.15, we get the area of this. So the area is 0.15 times 1 is 0.15. The area of this rectangle is 1 times 0.25. The area here is 1 times 0.35. So it's 0.35. And here the area is 0.15. The area here is 0.1. So the total area is equal to 1. So the area is equal to sigma px is equals to 1. Now, other books are using segments. Let's do it here. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. When the value is 1, this is 0.15. So here, when 2, 0.25. When the value is 3, 0.35. When the value is 4, 0.15. Yeah. And when the value is 5, 0.1. So some books are using probability histograms, some are using segments.